Green morning, green afternoon, green evening. It's indeed a great pleasure to have all our brothers and sisters across the world. Wherever you are, we pray to Almighty for your good health, your wellness, your well-being, and being taken care of everybody. So ladies and gentlemen, let's move on today. And we are moving ahead in our journey. And during this particular pandemic, today is 1110th webinar, 1110. And tomorrow morning, it's going to be 1111. That's the way we move on. We have got a very distinguished guest, Arijit Ji, and he is the chapter chairman for the Northeast Association of the Domestic Tour Operators of India. And having met him number of times physically on ground, having seen his dynamism, when we had met in Guwahati for a couple of functions, he's a wonderful soul, wonderful person, very dynamic, and his entire team is very vibrant. So our deepest regards and heartiest congratulations to all of them. They're doing a wonderful job. We know tourism industry is passing through difficult challenges. Honorable Prime Minister always says that the Asht Lakshmi, this particular region, all the 8 beautiful states what we have got, they have got a lot to offer, and India's cultural heritage is not complete without getting the whole cultural amalgamation, beautiful culture what we have got from this region. So we extend a very, very hearty welcome to Arijit Ji this evening. And of course, I'm grateful to my friend Shri P.P. Khanna Ji, who had come just 2 days before, and he was kind enough. He told, let's move on to Northeast and we will take on the president of the region also with us. So great thanks to Khanna Ji. Our chamber, International Chamber for Service Industry, which is a link between India and ASEAN, very specially. And when we talk about all the countries, wherever they are in the different continents, we've got 31 million non-resident Indians at present based out of, 149 countries. Now, these 31 million people are a very important people, a bridge between India and abroad, and this spring, sprinkling, giving the fragrance of Indian cultural heritage. On 13th, there is a parade in USA of the Swatantrata Divas just before our function, 15th of August in India. And that parade, if I show you the canvas and the color creative, you would be amazed how much efforts have been put in the dances, the music, the art, the craft, culture, cuisine, everything they are displaying over there. Let me take you back, ladies and gentlemen. Tourism being a part of the service industry, it got the maximum hit during this pandemic. And I can understand the pain, the difficulties, the problems, the challenges which industry has got. Today we would be sharing and we would hear the professional advice and the demand of the industry, particularly from the Northeast region. We will talk about it. Our chamber came into existence 27th year back. That is almost 27 years have passed. 1994 was the first Punjabi Parvasi Divas. And we have moved on and we had wonderful deliberations, celebrations, congratulations every year. And can you imagine that this year we had the virtual conference? Like last year, the Northeast Tourism Festival was virtually held, and Honorable Home Minister inaugurated that. When I was talking to the donor minister, we got a lot of valuable inputs from there, how much efforts were being put in by the entire travel trade. So it's great, great. And from 1994, we moved on. And in 2004, I still recall and I recollect that time, one of my senior officers from the armed forces, he was that time with the Government of India, Ministry of External Affairs, very vibrant and a very dynamic person. And he told, let's take a proposal to the Honorable Prime Minister. And thereafter, the Pravasi Bharatiya Divas got the birth, and the Honorable Prime Minister gave the vision. And late Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji, he told, let's start organizing Pravasi Bharatiya Divas from 2003 onwards. Ladies and gentlemen, a great, great effort. And I still recall from the Indian Army, I started my journey from the Northeast. I've seen all the colors, all the cuisine, all the cultures, beautiful people, such a vibrant people, ladies and gentlemen. And right from 1973 onward, I have got my alliances and emotional bond with the entire Northeast region. And when I look at it, before moving over there and coming thereafter, being the first Indian Army officer on deputation to the Ministry of Tourism as a regular Indian Army officer, it was a great journey. It was a great learning in the Ministry of Tourism. We had set up the travel and tourism institutions. We started a lot of resettlement courses of tourism, All India Tourism Quiz Contest. And now coming to little painful moments, 25th of March, 2020, complete lockdown in the country. And thereafter, you can well imagine the tourism got the first blow. And with tourism comes hotel industry, restaurants, aviation. And there are lots of other industries, those are directly, indirectly associated with tourism. And can you imagine how much employment, how much revenue, how much foreign exchange, how much domestic economic balance of payment the tourism brings? We will talk about it today. So like doctors, nurses, paramedical people doing great job, we took on the journey towards education and skills. And we started working on to it. And right from 25th of March, I still recall every moment, our patron all the way from USA, he told us, go ahead. Our president based out of Thailand, he told, let's move on. Dato Ramesh Kodamalji from Malaysia, from Cambodia, Sandeep Majumdarji, the president of Indian Chamber of Commerce. And then, of course, from Singapore, our chairman and our advisor, Anil Manochaji. And then World Tourism Day, you know, virtual celebration. Then we moved on to Scandinavian countries, and right from Sweden, Dr. Ravikant Pathakji gave us a lot of valuable input. And then we started organizing lots of virtual summits world over for the education skills. And I'm grateful to Mr. Eric Fault, the regional director, UNESCO, taking care of Bhutan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Maldives, and India, and all of them. And of course, with him, Mr. Omar, that also, thank you very much for your valuable support. And then Shri Shri Ravi Shankarji's nephew, Arvindji, he gave a wonderful vision to all of us. And we started Ayurveda for the Global Wellness Series. And that was something amazing. And thereafter, all our non-resident Indians, they told every Sunday, let's start a program exclusively what non-resident Indians can do for Indian education ecosystem. Then we went to ancient heritage and our wisdom also. We talked a couple of programs on that. Then we got the sector skill councils on board, Wellness Sector Skill Council, Monica Bahel, I'm so grateful to you. She brought last year 15 Yodha of the wellness industry on the 15th August, 15 August, Bharat ke Swatantrata Divas. And you would be happy to know, now also we are going to organize this year, once again, 15, you know, the Yodhas would be coming from the Beauty and the Wellness Sector Skill Council. And I'm also grateful to Mr. Mohit Soni, the Media Entertainment Sector Skill Council. We have done a large number of programs with them. Our chairman for, you know, the MSME, who is the former chairman and MD's NSIC for Chamber, he gave a lot of vision and we moved with the Sector Skill Council, basically for management, entrepreneurship and professional skill council. Then we entered the Middle East. I'm grateful to Anand Prakashji. And thereafter we had gone to Tata Consultancy Services. And we are grateful to Dinanath Kholkarji, the vice president and the global head Tata Consultancy Services. And thereafter, ladies and gentlemen, we moved on to Buddhism. We brought from world over, we had almost 65 webinars on Buddhist pilgrimage and Buddhist tourism in India. And I'm grateful to Venerable Dr. Dhammapiya, Secretary General, International Buddhist Confederation, Maling Gamoji, and of course, Mr. Wangri, all of them together. And then Dr. Christy Chang from Taiwan, Joint President of the IBC, and Swami Sarupriya Nandaji, the Minister and the Spiritual Leader for Vedanta Society at the New York. And then, ladies and gentlemen, we moved on in the journey, empowering teachers. Then we had a Lala Lajpat Rai series complete towards India's freedom struggle. On 1st of February, The Honorable Finance Minister announced 100 Scenic schools coming up in the PPP mode in India. We organized 31 webinars setting up Scenic schools. And our request is always, why not to have more Scenic schools coming up in Northeast also? Then we had the International Women Day deliberations, celebrations, and education is so important. Vasanta Panchami. And thereafter, 16 Sanskaras. We had done a special series, Four Generation in the Music. We brought the production houses and our chairman and writer, producer, director from Mumbai, who was the right hand of Yash Chopra ji. All the Hindi movies which have been shot in Switzerland and other places, he was the man behind. He's the chairman for our media entertainment sector. Then thereafter, ladies and gentlemen, World Youth Skills Day. And that is on 15th of July. I'm grateful to Professor Anil Sastrabuddhi ji, the chairman of the AICT, Dr. N.S. Kalsi, the chairman, National Council for Vocational Education and Training, Professor Vivek Shankar Natarajan, our advisor in USA, because there was a great celebrity, the gentleman who is a don of the service industry, and he is a moving encyclopedia when you talk about service industry. We move to Dr. Jagdish N. Sheth ji, who has been honored by the Honorable Prime Minister recently with a very decorated national award. And he was the key speaker. And it was such a wonderful journey that day and the deliberations. Then we moved on to MSME, plays a very important role. And particularly, I'm grateful to Ministry of MSME. 3.5 years, we had been going to the corridors of the ministry, from the Ministry of Commerce and Industry to the Ministry of MSME, that services sector to be brought at par with manufacturing sector. We are grateful to Nirmala Sitaraman ji, the Honorable Finance Minister of India. On 13th of May, she made an announcement that here onward, now the services sector will be at par with our manufacturing sector. Our glimpses of lots of events which we have organized in different states. We had gone to Nagaland, we had gone to Manipur, we had gone to Guwahati, we had lots of function at Radisson Blue Hotel. It's a beautiful hotel which is next to the Guwahati airport, and Guwahati being a gateway, and Guwahati city being such a colorful, such a wonderful city. And thereafter, we had the ASEAN program in Shillong when the ASEAN study center was set up. And thereafter, we had a couple of other Northeast ASEAN. Then in Mumbai, with the Ministry of Commerce and Industry on 30th June 2017, for the entire Northeast, we had the cinematic tourism deliberation and celebrations, and then Advantage Northeast. If you remember this particular moment, nobody can forget, because the Honorable Prime Minister and then the Bhutan Prime Minister and the galaxy from the whole country and the world over, when the people came to Guwahati, and that time we were with FICCI. Basically, we took care of the IT part and the telecom part in this particular celebrations and deliberations. And then, ladies and gentlemen, during this pandemic, teacher and youth empowerment, and we strongly believe education and skills are incomplete unless children get direct startup or entrepreneurship or employment. We are proud to share that with the help of the non-resident Indians, way back in 1994, we brought India's first finishing school for service industry. And then we always feel power is within the youth, and teachers need to be empowered, very, very important. Why don't we have tourism as an integral part of education ecosystem? Kindly have a look at it. This is the canvas of our chamber. We are going to have 147 webinars, different webinars, all on revival of tourism with the various stakeholders from the world over. And we are touching almost all aspects of tourism. That's what we are working. On 27 September this year, on the World Tourism Day, we are also launching E-Gurukul Gyan Yagya. That is a free education on service industry with a focus on tourism. For all those children who cannot afford education, you stay at your place. We will try and work out, you get your basic bandwidth, you get your basic device, and we have to remove the digital divide. Now we don't require physical infrastructures. What we require is digital infrastructure. Now, tomorrow is a very important day in the history. And that's why I was telling tomorrow, 1111, that is 1111. And that is because tomorrow is a International Youth Day. So ladies and gentlemen, we are going to have a first program that's coming up, saving youth from drugs. That is very important. And tomorrow in the evening at 8 p.m., like today you have got this program, you will be meeting 150 youth right on the canvas from the world over. And we're going to have the deliberations on whatsoever they want to talk. We want to take their views, the global youth confluence. So back to basics of life, basic food, basic health, basic education. And whatsoever human mind can conceive and believe it can achieve. Let's get together. All of us, we should get together. Let's move to northeast part of India, the beautiful Ashtalakshmi of India. Let's move with Arijit ji for the journey of domestic tourism in the beautiful northeast part of India. Join me in extending a very warm welcome to the chapter chairman, Northeast Association of Domestic Tour Operators of India, based out of Assam. Hearty welcome and a pleasure to have you with us. Namaskar. And indeed, it's a great, great pleasure. Whenever I have met you, Arijit ji, in Guwahati, it's always very vibrant interaction. You're a very, very dynamic person and your entire team is also very, very dynamic. We have already drawn the trail. We want to move on this trail with you. Hum aapke peeche khade hain, aap aage chaliye. And let's move on, all of us together, and let's take on the journey, domestic tourism in Northeast India.
Good evening, sir. Very good evening, Dr. Gulshan Sharma ji, ICSI International Chamber for Service Industry. Thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to give my presentation. On behalf of ADTY Northeast Chapter, I wish you and ICSI all the best. Thank you. With your permission, may I give my presentations?
Please, please go ahead. Please go ahead. Arijit ji is a veteran from travel and tourism industry. And whenever I have met him in Guwahati, I still remember a lot of deliberations. And he has organized a lot of colorful programs over there. Please go ahead. I'm giving you the time to share your presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you once again.
I'm just setting the context so that you get a time to share your presentation.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for that. So, ladies and gentlemen, you'll enjoy wonderful Northeast. And this evening, we have to distribute some cash prizes also. Keep posting your whatever Arijit ji asked you in between. And if you answer correctly, you win some prizes from the chamber today. Arijit ji, please go ahead.
Thank you.
Share screen. And I have to see your screen. I have to see your dashboard. It has yet to come.
I have already shared my screen.
Arijit ji, you have to come via that green button. You close it once. You close it once. No worries. You close it once. You close it once. And then come on share screen, the green button, arrow. And then come on your desktop. And that presentation of yours, you can just share with all of us. Meanwhile, let me extend a very hearty welcome to Balkrishan ji, Saurabh Tripathi, Priyanka Dhiman, Balkrishan ji, Vidhi Kishore, Kavita, Pandit ji, aapko bahut bahut sadar pranam. उसके बाद पंडित जी ने भारत का पहला टूरिज्म सॉन्ग लिखा, उसे गाया भी और उसका पूरा म्यूजिक भी कंपोजर्स के साथ किया. तो पंडित जी को बहुत बहुत हमारी तरफ से आभार है. सुभाष वर्मा जी, अ ग्रेट वेटरन ऑफ टूरिज्म. विमल जी, हु इज ज्वाइनिंग फ्रॉम यूके, अ ग्रेट वेलकम. हाँ जी, अभी आपका स्क्रीन आएगा. अभी आप जाइए पीपीटी एडीटीओआई एंड आईसीएसआई, उस पर क्लिक कीजिएगा. पीपीटी एडीटीओआई एंड आईसीएसआई. Then Kavita has written over here, having spectacular wildlife, culture, tribe, shrines of the diverse regions, ancient villages and historically important archaeological sites, Northeast part of India provides a wonderful opportunity to explore. That's great. Mamta Chauhan from Uttarakhand. Yes. Pandit ji, then Saurabh Tripathi ji, Gurinder ji. Yes, we have got. Hearty welcome to Sudhir Sopti ji, a dawn of Delhi tourism, And we are with Arijit ji. Your presentation is ready. And welcome to Arijit ji Northeast with you. Yes,
sir. Let's... Thank you once again. On behalf of Association of Domestic Tour Operators of India, ADTOI, a national body of domestic tour operators, constituted on 7th August 1996, with the express purpose of consolidating the efforts of all those tour operators which are actively engaged in the promotion of domestic tourism in the country. We are nearing 800 members all over India on the rolls and likely to enroll more members to a fold in the near future. So this is our 25th anniversary. On 7th of August, we have completed 25th anniversary, and from Northeast chapter, we wish you a heartiest welcome. As you're aware that we have 11 chapters in India, and Northeast is one of the chapters which started in April 2019. At present, we have about 25 members from Assam, Manipur, and Tripura. A list of Northeast chapters can be found in the website of www.adtoi.in, or you can email us at adtoinortheastchapter@gmail.com. We'll share the contact details of our Northeast chapter, consisting of following office bearers: chapter chairman, secretary, treasurer, lady entrepreneur officer. ADTOI Northeast chapter's first meeting was held in August 2019 at Guwahati, where Reiki 2 was of heritage work was discussed, along with women entrepreneurs from the fields of handloom, handicraft, cuisine, and of course tourism, tour guides, etc. ADTOI Northeast chapter played an important role in organizing B2B meet in Northeast festivals in New Delhi and last year through webinar in Guwahati. ADTOI Northeast chapter is associated with local college developing community-based tourism project. ADTOI Northeast chapter have proposed for reshaping tourism in Northeast regarding air connectivity in Northeast with special emphasis on Aizawl, Agartala, Aizawl, Aizawl, Imphal, Aizawl, also emphasizing on reduction of minimum price for Northeastern region as part of RCS and tax holiday for tourism, and reduction of VAT for ATF, waiver of landing and parking charges. The government may consider extending incentives to viability gap funding, VGF support, and all Northeastern states should be interconnected via flights and helicopter services. This is our community-based tourism. We have started our community-based tourism. And also our Lady Entrepreneur Office, LEO, which is a pioneer initiative of the Women Empowerment and CSR wing of Association of Domestic Tour Operators of India. The position was conceived and created in 2019 with the support of other governing body members of ADTOI. The vision of Lady Entrepreneur Officer is to empower women and bring them forward in the field of tourism. Each LEO from all the chapters of ADTOI takes initiatives according to our vision, interests, and expertise for women empowerment and CSR activities. Our LEO would connect and provide a platform to the lady entrepreneurs of ADTOI in promoting the tourism industry and empower the women leaders within, and would work to increase lady members in ADTOI. Our LEO would also reach out to the lady executives working with the members, and also non-ADTOI members who are connected to tourism and allied services. Acknowledging the importance to connect to the youth, a LEO would also reach out to female students in colleges, universities who are undergoing tourism courses. Very recently, a webinar was organized by ADTOI Northeast chapter on 28 June, Rebuilding Tourism in Northeast, Connecting Tour Operators, Hoteliers, and Service Providers. Theme: it is a time for us to plan for the new normal in tourism and be armed with our preparedness to welcome tourists to Northeast India. Discussions are crucial on making Northeast region safe and comfortable for our tourists, so that Northeastern region becomes a preferred region for travelers. At the same time, stakeholders are responsible towards our frontline tourism professionals, the drivers, the housekeeping staff, the guides, the front office executives. In the view to chart out a balance, a webinar to discuss the way forward for tourism in Northeast was. The webinar was inaugurated by India Tourism Northeast Regional Director, Mr. Shankar Shubhra Devbarma. And these are his words. These are unusual times, the situation the tour operators have been going through. Cannot even imagine in the remotest dream. It's a nightmare the tourism industry is facing throughout the world. I can understand the condition of our brothers and sisters of the industry. The time has to come to think together and find out the solution to overcome and global pandemic. We had a very, very fruitful discussion, sir. And moving on to Mr. P.P. Khanna, our president of ADTUSA, it's important to discuss how to rebuild tourism in Northeast, connecting tour operators, hoteliers, and service providers. It's very important during COVID times. We are passing through very harsh time and thinking of ways on how to revive, survive, and thrive. I'm happy that Northeast chapter, along with India Tourism Northeast, have called panelists from all over the seven states. Domestic tourism will be the savior for the tourism in India. I repeat, domestic tourism will be the savior for the tourism in India. ADTUI promotes domestic tourism in India, which is the demand of the Ministry of Tourism and demand of the stakeholders in India, because there are lots of restrictions in inbound and outbound tourism. We must concentrate our domestic tourism, how to revive, needs to discuss feedback from analysts as how to develop domestic tourism in Northeast, very important. That was from Mr. P.P. Khanna, president of ADTUI. Moving on, from Nagaland, Mr. Kejaro Kukperu, the Vice President of Nagaland Tourism Association, in the webinar said, Northeastern states have many festivals which are very important for tourism industry in the region. Hornbill Festival is not only the festival of Northeast India, it is the biggest cultural festival in the world. It is celebrated from 1st to 10th December every year. Last year, a virtual Hornbill Festival was organized due to COVID-19. For this year, it is a little premature to conclude what kind of Hornbill Festival we can have. It will depend on the COVID situation and the government will take the best decision. Not just Hornbill Festival, there's so many festivals in Nagaland and the government is trying to promote the festivals of each and every community. Thank you, Mr. Kejaro Kukperu, Vice President, Nagaland Tourism Association. Moving on from Mizoram, Mr. Joris Thangla. He is the General Secretary, Association of Tour Operators, Mizoram. Mr. Joris said, tourism and hospitality industry depends on the frontline tourism service providers. That's like drivers, guides, reservation staff, and they should be vaccinated. Yes, sir. In addition to the tourism stakeholders themselves, we also need to walk out on consumer confidence in our plans for our survival. The crisis is expected to have permanent impact. People will be very cautious about traveling and consumer behavior will change. We should be cautious to protect the service provider who are in the front line and follow COVID appropriate behavior in sensible manner. We have more than 100 of tour guides. I repeat, Mizoram has more than 100 of tour guides recently inducted by Mizoram Tourism, and they are being trained for COVID safety precautions and are being kept updated with public health guidelines so that they can adhere to them during the tours. Thank you, Mr. Zhou. Moving on, from Tripura, we have Mr. Shomin Datto, member, ADTUI Northeast Chapter, and Director, Hindustan Tours and Travels Tripura, with alerts about the third wave hitting in 6 to 8 weeks. We have to move conscious to take necessary measures. COVID-19 is the biggest challenge that the tourism sector has faced. Sir, it was a privilege that all the Northeastern states were under one umbrella. To continue, Mr. Shomin Datto said, we have to redefine the focus on how to rebuild the tourism sector. Very, very important. Tourism is dependent on service providers, hoteliers, transporters, and the tourists. The challenge will be to normalize the situation. It is very early. We do not know what will happen in next 2 to 3 months. Remember, this webinar was in June. Our frontliners are most vulnerable. The main question is how to overcome the crisis and rebuild ours. So we are all concerned, sir. The tourists should feel safe and comfortable in the region. We are prepared for that. We are getting prepared ourselves. Moving on to Manipur, Mr. Nivaran Nangmatem is the Secretary General Manipur Association of Tour Operators. Nivaran said, once the crisis comes to an end, there will be a tsunami of tourists coming to Northeast India. Thank you, Nivaran. And we need to rebuild ourselves as we have been seriously injured with the crisis. First, we need to secure ourselves by approaching the government for some kind of soft loan. Yes, this is very important, so that we can take care of the staff. Vaccination to all the staff, drivers, guides, and anyone related. See, everyone is talking about the vaccination of the frontline tour operators, tourism stakeholders. We need to conquer our fear. Tourists need to employ the people from region, and we use local authorities, tour operators. The mantra is, please come through local tour operators. We need to have committee to look into reviving tourism. Thank you, Mr. Nivar. Moving on to Meghalaya, Mr. E. Banglungla Bla. Kublai is the president of Northeast India Tourism Confederation, NEITC, and president Tour Operators Association of Meghalaya. Mr. Bla said, our first and most important focus should be to save lives and then save livelihood and save tourism. We need to help the community and support those who are in need. Vaccination is very important, and only after vaccination, saving the future tourism in Northeast will be possible. Future tourists will be very concerned about vaccination. So communities need to be made aware of vaccinations. Very true, Mr. Bla, and help. Confidence is very important for us. The stakeholders should believe that there is sunshine above the clouds. Yes, sir. And same goes for tourism in the future. Thank you, Mr. Bla. Moving on to Mr. Debojit Kumar Bora from Assam. He is the President, Tour Operator Association of Assam, TOA, and is the General Secretary of Northeast India Tourism Confederations. We need to generate confidence and trust among the tourists coming to Northeast India post-pandemic. Tourism frontline or professionals, driver, person at the reception desk, housekeeping, etc., need to be vaccinated so that tourists know that they are being held by a group of people who are free from COVID. Moreover, timely information to tourists should be a priority. Excellent. So we should work for uniform protocols in the region, which should be convenient to the tourists. Moving on to Mr. Sunil Sarab. He is the president and Hotel Restaurant Association of Assam. In these uncertain times, when you are talking of third wave, the market demand of the hotel industry is uncertain. Vaccination is very important, and the state government is leading the vaccination drive. We have approached the government to declare the hotel staff as frontline workers. It has not yet worked out. So we have decided that in case there is a delay, we'll ensure that all the hotel employees will be vaccinated if needed. Thank you, sir. Hotel SOP is more important. A digital solution will have to be found out. Guests will prefer digitalization as a safety net. Moreover, the role of the employee will be significant. There will have to be multi-tasker for the hotel. Also, the hotel management need to reassure the staff and give them confidence of job security. That is very, very important. A positive mind is very crucial for revival. Thank you, Mr. Sarah. Moving on to Mr. Kishan Kibriwal. He is the chairman and Managing Director of Hotel Polo Tower Group, Meghalaya. I would like to bring the light some concerns of the hoteliers. Refund of GST inputs credit by the government, bank guarantees are blocked with Government of India for EPCG obligations. If those obligations could be waived off and bank guarantees can be released, that would add liquidity for the hoteliers. SEI's credit available with government could be released. State and central government subsidies are due to hoteliers. If those subsidies can be paid immediately, it will be useful. The cost, the CGST payment should be deferred for the next 2 years, not a waiver, but if it could be deferred. In the tourism, we are running some facilities in the PPT format with the government. I urge the state government to extend the PPT lease. We are facing liquidity crunch. We all are facing liquidity crunch. If we take loans, we have to repay. These are funds used to us from various government departments. Thank you, Mr. Kishan Kibriwal. Now, building trust among tour operators and hoteliers. You know, our tour operators and the hoteliers have to have a good relationship, which will be vital for the revival of tourism. This is very, very important. The key factors would be trust, commitment, coordination, the quality of communication and the exchange of information, participation, and use of very constructive resolution techniques. Another important aspect will be cancellation policy, which will play very important role post-COVID. With a flexible and lenient cancellation policy, hotels can reassure the guests and give them incentive to book. Just before the pandemic, ADTY Northeast chapter held a networking session between the Hotel and Restaurant Association of Assam. It was on 27 February 2020. Now, we all participated, and this is all before the pandemic, and we decided how we can go together, hand in hand. In post-COVID-19 world, travelers will travel to destination that make it easy to maintain social distancing practices. This is very important, sir. This may take the form of itineraries focusing on more remote locations or even the increased popularity, such as birding tours, biking tours, archaeological sites, or textile tours, where travelers are less likely to come into contact with others. We urgently need to conduct training programs to create awareness in the villages and the rural areas. We have to take community into confidence and educate them. We as tourism professionals and associations should take up program and community development program to be arranged by professionals like us. We need to go to the grassroots level and do kind of awareness campaign. Now, textile tours. This is in all over Northeast. You know, this is an excellent product, textiles in Northeast. This is in Mizoram. This photograph is showing Mizoram. Textile tools in Manipur. You know, so this could be a product. Now, Eriwa. This is Eri silk is known as the Indi or Erindi in India. It's a white silk. It's often referred as the fabric of peace when it is processed without killing the silkworm. The process results in a silk called Ahimsa silk, non-violent silk. Moths leave the cocoons, and then the cocoons are harvested to the spark. So textile is very, very important in the tourism industry. We have to move from the regular tourism. Like spinning, weaving, you know, these are the textile products all over Northeast. You know, this is the baby wrapper, you know, made of Eri. Textile is the heart and soul of tourism, ladies and gentlemen. Now we move to some of the destinations. Just showing the glimpses of the states. You know, it will not be possible to discuss everything because of the shortage of time. Now, what is starting with Mizoram, the songbird of the Northeast, sociable, hospitable, and fun-loving. The Mizos are the finest bird singers living in the heart of nature, being woken up by the bird song reflex affinity to the best attractive features of the land. Ladies and gentlemen, we move on to the Tropic of Cancer in Mizoram. How many of you are aware the Tropic of Cancer passes through Mizoram? Please visit Mizoram, the Solomon temples, and the Chapchurput festival, which is held in every year in the month of March, or visit the Red Mountain, which is 1584 meters high. So these are the places. How many of you visited? I doubt so. It's time you visit Mizoram, you visit Manipur, one of the loveliest destinations in the Northeast. Manipur is slowly slipping into mainstream tourism. This photograph is taken by one of my friends from Manipur. This is, you know, this is the secret is that when you're flying to Manipur, to Imphal, just before landing, provided you're sitting on the right side of the aircraft, you'll see this Loktak Lake from the airport. It is a wonderful, so whenever you fly to Imphal, please book your seat on the right-hand right window seat. Don't miss it. Or if you miss it, then you go to the Loktak Lake and view the sunrise at Loktak Lake. This is a wonderful lake. And then visit the Ima Market, the Mother's Market. 3,000 mothers are there in Ima Market. You won't see this kind of product in anywhere in India. So ladies and gentlemen, request you please visit these areas through your tour operators. Do not Google. You will not be able to visit these places. Textiles of Manipur. These are the most wonderful textiles. Now Tripura, it's this cultural synthesis. The beauty of the erstwhile princely state of Tripura stems from the splendor of its natural setting and its dazzling heritage. This is the Nirmal, around 50 kilometers from Agartala. This is the view on your left is the Nirmal from the inside, and the Ujjainta Palace in the Agartala. See the products we have. Then Unakoti, this is a wonderful thing. This is 4.5 hours drive from Agartala, and these are the rock carving, probably second or third BC. And most important is that flag lowering ceremony at Indo-Bangladesh border. Ladies and gentlemen, do not compare with Wagah border. This is a very synchronizing manner, which has been done just before the sunset. And, you know, this is something that he, from Bangladesh side, that India side, they come, is just 10 minutes from Agartala. So, ladies and gentlemen, please do not miss this flag lowering ceremony at Indo-Bangladesh border. Once again, I repeat, it is the tour operators who will be able to take you these products. Moving on to Nagaland. Nagaland tribes are India's pride, land of myths and festivals, brave warriors and tribal rituals. Nagaland, with its capital Kohima, lures the adventures of heart. It's a colorful people, great verdant landscape, and its cultural strength are a delightful combination for a memorable holiday. Hornbill Festival, everyone is aware of. Angami women photo you can see over there of Kohima. And the Konyak tribe, there are 16 tribes, and you can visit these tribes through the tour operators. Please visit through the tour operators. And here comes Arunachal Pradesh. Early riser Arunachal, the land of rising sun, and a unique holiday destination. Visit the Tawang Monastery and Apatani tribe in Zero. See the colorful tribes. And Meghalaya. Meghalaya is aptly called the abode of the clouds. It's one of the India's prettiest state inhabited by castles. Now, this is this photograph is of Shangspadang. Now, the river is crystal clear, but it will crystal clear between November and February. You know, if you come in the month of April, you probably will not see that, because when the rain starts, that crystal clarity, you know, moves away from there. So again, ladies and gentlemen, please visit the tour operators. And then there's the double-decker road bridge. Now, the problem with the double-decker road bridge, the people have started going there. You know, it's overcrowded now. People are taking selfies. This has to be avoided. So that is the reason the local people, they have stopped on Sunday's entry of visitors, you know. Because, see, these road bridges, they are, you know, this is something, it's a biodiversity thing. You know? So this is a product which cannot be, people cannot be overloaded over there on these bridges. One has to, you know, has to compromise with the local people. So again, I again repeat, please visit two tour operators. And this is the view of Meghalaya. You know, if you go on the monsoon, you have a different view. If you go on the winter, it's a different view. Remember, most of the waterfalls are totally dry during winter. So monsoon time, you see the more of the waterfalls, more active there. Now, Assam. That is my last presentation. Assam, dominated by the mighty Brahmaputra River and well-known Kaziranga and Manas National Park. There are other wildlife sanctuaries, and also home to the world's largest inhabited riverine island, Majuli. There are many products, ladies and gentlemen, but I am just giving you just the glimpses of these products. And, you know, birding. We are not showing photographs of rhinos. You have probably have seen all the presentation with rhinos and things, but this is something, elephant bathing. This is a wonderful thing. You don't see elephant bathing. See the Mahout, how Mahout, this is his child. He is washing his elephant, bathing the elephant. The elephant is bathing himself. This is a product you will not see. I doubt you will not see anywhere. Now, birding is something very, very important. We should, as I said, in the initial birding, cycling, and all this should be taken into consideration. And Majuli, Assam. Now, when you visit Majuli, it is, you are in a different world. You know? But again, to visit this, you have to visit through tour operators of the respective states. Ladies and gentlemen, that was my small presentations. Thank you very much, and God bless.
Amazing, amazing, wonderful, wonderful. Such a wonderful presentation, such a wonderful presentation, Arijit ji. You took all of us mentally over there. You can just close your screen so that we both will come in front. You can just close your laptop screen and we both will come in front. Yes, there we are. Let me clap for you. It was a wonderful journey. Without charging any money from any tourist, you have given them all the 8 beautiful states and such a nice one. And you know, Subhash Verma ji, your past president, he is joining. He says, Arijiti is such a wonderful person. I said, I endorse, he is wonderful. We have also been joined by Mr. Shiring Wonge, the Northeast India Tourism Confederation. They all are coming on Saturday and we have got a big gathering that day. That's something is lovely. And DK Boraji, how can I forget? Because Secretary, Ministry of Commerce and Industries, Government of India, along with 75 people, we had gone over there. And the cruise which we enjoyed in the evening over there, that beautiful musical evening with the snacks and the dinner and everything. My deep thanks to the cruise and Mr. DK Boraji. That was something lovely. And today you have made us familiar and traveled to so many places. And we are grateful that you introduced us to so many dignitaries from travel and tourism. Abhi, aapka Arijit ji, as far as the government of India is concerned, the points what you put across, you have put it in a beautiful way from your members, from your region, and everything you have given it to us. And also you have mentioned very politely over here, two things very interesting. Building trust among tour operators and hoteliers. That's the first point you made very strong. And with that, we would like to also add building trust among tourists as well, those are visiting over there. Now people, NRIs, those are joining us from the world over, and those want to come to Northeast. Of course, there are procedure, they will follow, they will understand, they will do everything and all. They are just interested to know that is there any centralized arrangement for the entire Northeast? Because in certain states, you require a inner line permit and you require a special international tourist permit when you're coming over there and a couple of other things. So is there any centralized arrangement at Guwahati or somewhere? If somebody is interested, because somebody has asked me even a question, if I come to India, what do you feel? How many days trip I take it to Northeast? So it's a very difficult question for me to answer because it depends on the budget. It depends on how many days. And it depends on a couple of other things, but I would request Arijit ji, kindly just take on that and please give some inputs on it.
Thank you, sir. First of all, I'd like to remind you that Northeast is, we are bounded by the China and other countries. So Arunachal has to be there, restricted area permits is there. So where special permits can be arranged, which takes maximum of 7 days for the foreign nationals. That should not be a problem. But tourists, international tourists visiting places like Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, they do not require any permit. They do not require any permit. They have to report to FOC, that is foreign office, and that is the police stations near in the respective states. But the thing is that again, when you have the international tourists, they are traveling to tour operators, and everything has been is arranged by the tour operators. So as I said repeatedly, you know, please visit to tour operators, you will not have any problem. Regarding visiting all the 7 states, remind I have given presentation 7 states, not the 8 states. If you want to cover all the 7 states, you know, minimum it will take 21 days to 30 days. You know, now depending, as Dr. Pilchan Shambhaji said, depending on the permit, it can be budget, it can be arranged, you know, and your kind of thing. Now suppose, as I said, your interest is wildlife or your textiles, based on that, or mix of anything, we can arrange that. All the tour operators of ADTI chapters and other associations, they will be able to arrange your fantastic tour. You'll go back, you know, you will go back. You come as a tourist and you'll go back as a friend.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. One more point we would like to take on, very interesting. When we talk about the greenery, when we talk about the forest covered area, it is maximum in the Northeast when we take the entire India into considerations. Now, particularly post pandemic and during pandemic, Ayurveda has come in a very big way. particularly for immunity boosting and precautions and other remedial measures which are to be taken. And world over, slowly and gradually, Ayurveda is becoming very popular. And you would be so very happy to know that the commercial ads are coming in Canada, UK, and in USA of Ayurveda. Now going one step, in Tejpur, Patanjali has set up, with the investment of 1,000 crores, a plant over there, and approximately 1,100 people, our children are employed at present over there. Those are working. Now, with the help of the Ministry of Ayush, which is taking care of Ayurveda and herbals and herbal plantation, herbal growth and medicinal values and nutrition, whatsoever has to be taken, that is one part. Second part, like Sikkim has developed the entire thing in the organic form. And of course, we have got the beautiful tea gardens in Assam and other places. How do you look at Northeast emerging for wellness tourism, herbal tourism, Ayurveda tourism, and of course, green tourism, nature tourism, and Ministry of Forest, Ministry of Environment and Forest, Ministry of Ayush and Ministry of Tourism as a golden triangle? How do you look at that?
Sir, for the future is excellent over here. But I would like to add one in addition to Ayurveda. You know, Northeast is famous for bell metal works, you know, bell metal cars. And so when tourists, they are having the lunch on and the utensils made of bell metal, the immunity, you know, gets better and better every day, you know. So, and most of the restaurants now, they are serving on bell metal utensils. Moreover, in addition to the non-vegetarian, vegetarian foods are available now everywhere in Northeast, you know. Earlier, it was a little difficult. Now, in Guwahati, you will get Jain food, you know, and I'm sure we'll get it in place. In fact, 3 years back, a friend of mine, KV from Nagaland, told me that in Kohima also, they are serving some Jain food over there. And that is something, you know, there's a change we have seen because for almost 30 years in this trade, I've seen the changes. And it's really wonderful to see. Even though for international tourists, they are preferring the vegetarian food, you know, while they're traveling. So, yes, definitely Ayurvedic things will definitely come up. No, but we have to little organize ourselves.
Okay, wonderful. One more point last I will take on, because my appetite has increased after seeing such a wonderful presentation of yours. Let's look at it cinematic tourism. When I talk about Bollywood tourism, when I talk about Tollywood tourism, when I talk about Pollywood tourism, when we take the entire media entertainment industry together, where the films, commercial films, ad films, music albums, TV serials, and couple of other things, you know, which are related to that, the entire Northeast children are musical. They are so talented. I would say I always feel very happy that the director, tourism and director education for Nagaland and Meghalaya, when they made a presentation at Radisson Blue in Guwahati during the conference, they came on the stage with a guitar, they sung the song, and then they started with the presentation. It was amazing. How do you look at it that if these state governments in the Northeast, they get encouraged, and we have already done the experiment in Mumbai, we took all the 8 states together, and we had organized a curtain raiser for cinematic tourism full day with the production houses and all. How do you look at the potential? Because it will bring employment, entrepreneurship, startup, infrastructure development, and couple of other things which will come up. How do you look at cinematic tourism? Kyunki main bhula nahi hu Koila movie ka shooting in Arunachal Pradesh, and of course, Brahmaputra, a lot of movies, and Bhupen Hazarika's, the songs and the tunes and everything, not only SMEs, but they have traveled to the Hindi Bollywood films also. How do you look at cinematic tourism?
Definitely, sir. Let me share up a point. As you mentioned Koila movie, Sharing Wange was of Himalayan Holidays was part of this Koila movie. Okay. And Guwahati office in Guwahati office, my office, where he kept all those air tickets. Those days, the air tickets were like a jacket, you know. So the management has to come and collect the air tickets, you know.
Yeah.
And Shering Wange has done maximum, contribution in these films as a supplying of many, you know, actors, they're sending them to Tawang and other places. Before that, Sharin and myself, along with the director of tourism, we all went and checked the hotels where the actors would be staying. And after the Koyla movie, Arunachal has had a tremendous traffic of tourists going over there. So yes, tourism will really help. Unfortunately, in Meghalaya, one of the movie, they shot the movie, but unfortunately during that monetization and all those things, that the date of release clashed, and the movie, the Rock On movie, didn't click on. But otherwise, yes, definitely, every destination has to be, any movie is shot over there, and then next day when the picture is released, people strength to move on that those areas. Yes, cinematics will definitely help us. I'm sure Sharin Wange, if listening, he will agree to that.
Thank you. And the last word, what would you like to tell the youth of the Northeast from the travel and tourism industry? What would you like to tell them, those are thinking to be a part of travel and tourism industry, how they should prepare themselves? You have worked very hard for the last 3 decades. What would you like to tell them?
As I said in the beginning, I mentioned about the budding thing. You know, budding is very, very important, because Northeast has a number of residential birds, you know, and these birds, they are moving down from Bhutan to our areas. So, and the budding itineraries and budding tourists, there's a lots of potentials. So people, as a student, should really learn this and take these budding courses, you know, and this is going to help them, because budding will not affect, because our season is November to April, but residential buds could be 8 months, 10 months, even could be 12 months. You know, we have the lesser adjutant stock and better adjusted stock in Guwahati, where, you know, they are extinct, but we can see them over here. So, you know, every areas have some things, like in Arunachal Pradesh, they have the eagle nest, and that is something quite a remarkable area for the bird watchers. So I will suggest them, they should go on to birding along with cycling together, which will help them.
Wonderful. Amazing. Wonderful evening. With these words, thank you very much, Arijit Purkastaji. It was such a wonderful to have you this evening with us, giving us such a beautiful different colors on the same canvas of the entire Northeast. We look forward to yet another, and all the people, those are watching from world over, while we convey green morning and green afternoon and green evening to you in your time zones, take a trip to Northeast part of India, and Arijit ji would always be there to facilitate you and felicitate you. Both the areas I will take into consideration. With these words, thank you very much for joining us today, and we look forward to meet you yet on some other occasion. Wishing you all a wonderful evening, morning.